after what feels like absolute months of waiting, we've had lost passports, we've had cancelled holidays, everything. We are finally going to Disney. It has been absolute months in the making. And today is just going to be our kind of like pre-travel day and travel day vlog all in one. I didn't want to do just a pre-travel day just because, like, there's not much to do in a pre-travel day, but I wanted to include it because we are going to the airport. We are going to stay at the airport tonight, so I wanted to give you a tour of the hotel. And then we are going to be going to Disney tomorrow. So I'm going to kind of mix the two vlogs together, do a pre and a full travel day. So you'll get to see everything from like dinner tonight, the hotel, and then when we fly to Disney tomorrow. So this is the start of the vlog. I'm so excited. We're going to take Margot. The last time you guys saw her, she was 1 month old. She's now two and a half. And this is our first kind of big holiday. So I'm looking forward to seeing how it goes. So after EasyJet's new change in their sort of bagging rules, it's really expensive now to bring hand luggage with you, like a case. So I've gone for this backpack. Now this was actually bought from a charity shop. It's actually a really rare Disney bag. And we managed to pick it up for like £8 in the charity shop. So this is gonna be what I'm taking with all of my stuff in. And actually it fits so much in. There's 4 days worth of outfits in there, a laptop, all like chargers, all the stuff that I'd need, and it's gonna be really handy. Where are we going? Where are we going? Yeah, we are, aren't we? Disneyland. Last time you saw her, she was 1 month old and a ball of meat. Are you excited? Yeah. Okay. You ready?
Yeah.
You ready?
Yeah.
Your jumper even says Paris. Anyone think we're going there? You excited?
Yeah.
Give us a big clap. Woohoo! We're going to go out for some breakfast first. Yeah, we'll go out for some breakfast. So we're going to go out for breakfast with Emily's parents first. Just before we go to the airport. It's Emily's birthday this week. So you excited for Mummy's birthday? Yeah. Merry breakfast. Happy Ash Brown.
Thank you.
What you got?
A brown.
Ash Brown. Had pre-breakfast. I said to you, you're not on holiday if you've not had a pre-breakfast before your actual breakfast. Now we're really on holiday.
What's happening?
we're very happy to be going now because it was cancelled. How many times have it been cancelled?
Twice.
Two times.
So first time we booked it February, and then we had to cancel it because of COVID. And then the second time we booked it for the beginning of our summer holidays because we're both teachers. And the passport office very kindly lost my passport. So we ended up moving it again, paying a pretty penny to move it again, and then went on a little caravan holiday when we should have been to Disney.
Which was really good.
Yeah, it was very good.
I was a bit sceptical at first of all UK caravan. I went when I was a kid, I went on some, and but like I was like, no, it was like you go on holiday and you're gonna go abroad. But actually, caravan holiday was brilliant.
Yeah, it was really good.
But we have been really looking forward to this, and Margot loves like Disney princesses,
yeah,
loves all that Mickey sort of Mouse. Stuff. Mickey Mouse, yeah. You know, it's all she watches. So for her, this is just gonna be immense. I don't even think there could be anything better than Disneyland.
It's gonna be so good. So I grew up sort of going to Florida with my parents. I was really, really lucky as a kid, and they took me sort of every other year. And the goal, of course, is to get to Florida. But right now we're getting married next year. We've just bought a house. And so Disneyland Paris is a really good alternative till we can get there. And I think for the amount that you pay to get there, especially now, I think we're going to wait till she's like six, aren't we, to go? She's two now.
Yes.
And I think we're going to wait till she's six because like I went the first time when I was six, and I do remember it, but it's a lot of money to pay if she's not really going to remember it and she can't do much because obviously there's quite a lot of height restrictions. We've been all over the place, been to like Chessington and Potter's Park and things this summer.
We've done loads so far.
And there's quite a few things that she couldn't do, and we just thought, oh, I wonder what it would be like if we went to Disney.
You're not going to spend thousands for your kid to not be able to do anything, really. Yeah. So Paris is really good. It's got loads of little rides.
It's
so
up the road, isn't it, as well?
So. Oh, the road?
It's up the road.
It's in another country. But yeah, so we've had pre-breakfast. We're now going to go have breakfast at Josie's. If you know, you know.
and we'll see you there.
Just finished our Josie's. What would you rate?
Oh, 11 out of 10.
I'd probably go for... So I usually have the American breakfast, but because we're having giraffe later on today, I didn't want to be fat.
Probably eat that much tonight.
Yeah, but I just didn't need to eat too much. I didn't want to be a pig and eat loads when I didn't need to, so...
Oh, also, just want to confirm, earlier when we said we're having pre-breakfast, we weren't actually having like a whole breakfast, we just had a hash brown.
It was just a snack.
It was just a hash brown, and then we just actually had lunch with my parents.
But the Josie's, I just had a small breakfast today because I'm going to have dinner later. But still, always 11 out of 10. But we're now on the way to Gatwick. As you can see, Sprog is asleep, so...
We've got about an hour until we get there, so yeah. And we're going to go to Gatwick North Terminal parking, which I don't think we've done before, because I don't think, did we fly from North Terminal last time?
I can't remember.
We didn't use Gatwick anyway, we think we used APH or something like that. And then we've got the Premier Inn tonight at North Terminal, so mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, traffic's bad.
Shade traffic. Ooh. Be brutal. Stopped off at Cobham because we've got 45 minutes to kill. Can't actually check into the hotel or park the car until 3, so time to get a coffee. Got the coffees.
Oops.
Gone for iced because it's hot.
Gone for hot because it's hot.
We're at the airport. Are you waving to the airport?
I think I've gone the wrong way.
Oh no. Yeah. Well, we're at North Terminal. That's where we're flying from, so...
Short stay.
Well,
I've gone the wrong way.
No.
Uh-oh.
For God's sake. But we're here. That's the main thing. We're here. Oh. We're at Gatwick. We just got to find a Premier Inn now. Get the car parked. And check in. On our way to the summer special car park. Why is it called the summer special car park?
Because I think it's a special offer they do in the summer.
Wow, revolutionary.
Going the right way now.
Yeah, finally going the right way. Once we park the car, we've got to go to the Premier Inn. Is it far away from the
car park? I don't know. I think there's a shuttle bus that takes us there.
Even better. How much was the parking? Just let me know. How much was it?
£80 for 4 nights. And that is also with... discounts. If you sign up to like My Gatwick or something like that, you get 10% off parking. So yeah, I found that out.
Yeah, so that's a really handy tip actually.
Hi everybody, welcome to Summer Special Gatwick. My name is Linda here and I'm the assistant checking in people today. So sir, on this line please.
Yeah, look, she's so good at her job. Look
on
at her.
On this line.
Look, she's so good at her job.
Okay, so just quick room tour of the Premier Inn. So we paid £125 for the night because obviously we are flying early tomorrow. So we've got a bathroom just there. We did do a version of this earlier, but the sound was a bit funny and there's a very excitable Margot. Say hi.
Hi.
So yes, we got the big double bed for me and Kat. We've got Margot's bed over there. It fits her little pram in as well, which is really handy. We don't have much of a view and you can't open the windows, so you can't really see, but you can see some planes over there in the distance. You've got a little desk, we've got the laptop for editing, and then yeah, that's it.
So we're just going for some dinner now. We're just going to find giraffe in the South Terminal.
Yes, so we're in North Terminal at the moment and we're going to get the tram, isn't it?
Yeah, we're just on the old travelator.
Fair enough. And then just over there
is the tram. That takes you over to South Terminal. So we're going to go there, have a look at giraffe, see what they've got.
And probably have a look back around North Terminal as well.
Yeah, just look at like some of the shops maybe.
Get some breakfast for Margot for tomorrow.
Just
just got into the south terminal, walking around, gonna try and find Giraffe, which is just upstairs. We have to get the lift up there, do we? Yeah, so we have to get the lift up to Giraffe. You know, it's a lot quieter than I thought it'd be, but then we are in the arrivals area, so it could just be that. But it does, it feels really quiet. Here they are. Come to Giraffe for dinner. Size of their menu is huge. They've got loads of stuff. I think I'm going to go for the classic burger, though. What do you think you're going to go for? Margot, what are you having for dinner? Pizza. It's a huge menu, though. Really, really big. And for an airport, fairly reasonably priced. A little bit expensive, but I'm either going to go for the classic burger or the pulled barbecue beef and slaw. Emily's gone for burger and chips. She's got a kid's one because she's a bit full up, but actually looking at it, they're pretty much the same size. Margot's got pizza and chips. And I've gone for a classic beef burger with some cheese in there, some onions. Looking really good. I've got an acai. Margot's got water. And then you are waiting for yours, aren't you? So just to show you, this is what we ordered. Everything here. Got a beer, a cocktail. I got the burger. Emily got her burger. Margot got her pizza, and it comes to £37, which for an airport is really good. Really impressed with that. So it's 9:15 now, and we're gonna go to bed because it is, well, I've been up since 5 because I was excited for the holiday. But yeah, we're gonna go to bed now. We've got to get up at about 5 o'clock tomorrow morning. So it's been quite a long day already. We've done loads, but just thought I'd let you know that we're going to bed. Sun the pre-travel day off here, and then it's actual travel day tomorrow morning where we will be flying with EasyJet to Paris.
Good morning. Where are we going? On the aeroplane. Are you excited? Chord 6. We're going to go to the lounge first, aren't we? Yeah, so what lounge is it?
The O2 Roam Free.
And you got it for free, didn't you? Because you were O2. Absolute win. So we're gonna go there, see how it goes. We've got a nice new shiny blue passport. We got put to the family security, which the line is considerably shorter, which is a massive win. And this seems a lot easier, doesn't it? Just checked into the O2 lounge for a free lounge.
Yeah, I didn't even know about it. My dad sent me it. It was an O2 priority. So if you come into Gatwick, check your O2 priority because you get in for free, and you get given like a little wristband.
A free snack and a drink.
Free snack and a free drink. Yeah.
Yeah, that saves you what, like 6-7 quid.
Yeah, but for Margot, she got fruit and orange juice and cheese, so that was really good. And I just got a Diet Coke.
And security took a little bit longer though, but we still managed to get in.
About 10 minutes though.
Yeah, but they usually hold your booking for 15 minutes.
Yeah.
But when we got here, they said that's fine. Absolutely, we got here about 5-10 minutes late, so it's alright. So come in, absolutely fine. And for a free lounge, you can't go wrong.
What have they got in here, Margot? We've got Disney Plus and lovely beanbags for you to sit on. On our way down to our gate number 106. As you can see just out there, it's quite hard to see actually, but there are some EasyJet flights. There was one just taking off, wasn't there? Oh my gosh, not long. What are we on, Margot? Airplane. We've had a delay. How long?
I don't know if they said 15 minutes. So 15, but the flight's only 5 minutes late, so.
We have a customer traveling.
landed in Paris. Where's our next stop, Margot? Where are we going to go now? Yeah. It's currently just about 4 minutes till 11, and we need to get to 2F, which is all the way up here, for 11 o'clock for our magic shuttle. Or we have to wait till 12, so it's a big race against time at the moment. We're a bit lost right now. We don't really know how to get to the magic shuttle. We can see one over there. It was meant to be 11. It's like 3 minutes past 11, 4 minutes past 11 now. So I think we might have missed the one that we're meant to go on. But there weren't very clear instructions. So now we're just kind of going to see if that's our bus. Is this our bus? I don't know. What is that? What? Oh my. Thank you.
The M&S wasn't really an M&S, it was a little bit sketchy.
Okay. Oh, that looks very orange.
I know, right? It's the best. Some very weird ones for Haribo's because we know what colours are.
Oh, yum.
Twist,
Margot. Lovely.
€9.70.
Yeah. Wow, that's not that bad. We've made it to Sequoia Lodge, and what a beautiful hotel this actually is. I mean, to me it feels a bit like Animal Kingdom Lodge from Florida. It looks a bit like that, and you'll see why in a second as we go up to the reception entrance just over here. You can see it has that same sort of vibe about it. It just looks beautiful. So we're gonna go here, gonna check ourselves in, and then get straight down to the Avengers campus. This is the reception area. Emily's just checking in. This is Bambi themed, this one, but it looks amazing. Just so nice. How are you feeling?
Very lucky to be here.
It is. It is a beautiful hotel.
Yeah.
It is really nice.
But yes. It is very nice.
Oh, it's so worth it. So this is the outside of Sequoia Lodge. We've just been put in the wrong room, so we're just getting that changed at the moment, but I just thought I'd show you the outside. It is beautiful out here, and this is how close we are to the park. Disney is literally just there. It's just so relaxing. I could sit out here all day and be on holiday. But yeah, we're just getting the room changed, and then hopefully we'll have the right room because we just didn't have a bed for her, which was really annoying.
Okay, so we're finally in the right room after all the hassle. So you come in, you've got the door there, and then if you turn around, you've got your bathroom and a little bit of storage as well. So you've got a sink, and then you go in and you've got a toilet and a decent shower. Oh, that was so cute. Look at that shampoo. Okay, you go around. Oh, you got a safe as well, which is good. And then you come round, and then you've got a big double bed, some cute lights with little reindeers on, because this is the Sequoia Lodge is Bambi themed. Oh, you've got some characters up there as well, and then the artwork as well. And then we've got Margot's bed, which looks a bit clinical, but it's fine. It's better than sharing the big double bed with her. And then we've got the TV, a mirror, and then our view is just a bit countryside vibes. And yeah, that's it.
So that is the end of our travel day. Well, pre-travel day and travel day all at once. It's been a long 2 days.
Very tired.
We are now really excited. What we're going to do, we're just going to freshen up a little bit, and then we're going to get going straight to the park. Obviously, we're not going to show you that yet. That will be in the next vlog. Anything else you want to say?
No.
No, she's too tired. Right, see you at the parks.